The Mitiana Municipality MP, Francis Zake, has been a regular visitor of the Parliamentary Committee on Rules, Privileges and Discipline, where he has battled two cases of misconduct, one against Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayewa and another against the Rakai District Woman Member of Parliament, Juliet Chinyamatama Subi. Father Charles Unen, the Vice Chairperson of Parliament's Rules, Discipline and Privileges Committee, noted that Zake's cases of misconduct dominated committee business.
I just thank him for giving us work. Had it not been him, the committee would have been so dull. By giving us work accurate, he has made us busy. He has made members of parliament to learn the geography of the rules and how to handle misconduct of members of parliament, and how also to investigate a member who has what misbehaved, and also to give recommendation to parliament. I think this committee on rules will be the most active, but it is also quite challenging to discipline your very own brother or honorable member of the house.
Onen says the committee has no powers to terminate the proceedings and will be asking for extension of time to continue with their probe this year.
It's not within our mandate to terminate the proceedings of that investigation as committee. As committee, we have requested the speaker to extend the days because it coincided by the time we wanted to conclude the first case, the first investigation, members of parliament were now going to Kigali for the interparliamentary games. So that made it impossible for us to raise quorum. In any case, we have not lost hope.
On his assessment of the discipline of MPs in the 11th Parliament, Onen proposes that the Committee of Rules be given full powers to initiate proceedings against any errant legislator.
The Rule 175, our rules of procedure, all that the Committee on Rules investigate are initiated by the presiding officer. We wanted some amendment to be made such that the Committee on Rules can initiate certain.
Onen, who doubles as the Gulu East MP, has expressed regret over the recent boycott of the opposition MPs from plenary sittings, saying had the opposition attended plenary sitting on that day the Petroleum Supplies Amendment Bill was considered, perhaps they would have saved Uganda from passing such a monopolistic law.
The walking out, though it is constitutional, but it was too long. The members of the opposition were out for nearly a month, and there were important bills like the oil bill or the petroleum bill, which was passed, and some bills which were passed when they were not there. I know the government or the ruling party can take advantage of the absentia of those with dissenting views to pass bills which will suit their interest. And I believe if the opposition were in the house, that bill would have taken a different route.
He has asked Ugandans not to overwhelm their MPs with demands such as attending and contributing to birthday parties, saying such demands are crippling MPs financially. His call comes on a backdrop of over 10 MPs who have been jailed for failure to meet debt obligations.
Parliament has done its best to give an orientation to all members of parliament. But what I think what we need to, members of parliament should be given thorough financial discipline, financial management, you know, techniques. The money we receive can be enough if we tame our financial appetite.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at parliament.